Don't want to spend money on Leonardo or Midjourney? Well, here's a way to generate unlimited images without spending a dime, just by hitting play on a few code blocks. Here, I'll show you how. Today on AI World, we'll walk you through how to do stable diffusion in Google Collab. To give you some background, Google Collab is a free platform that lets you run Python code on cloud servers. It's like having a powerful computer at your fingertips without the hassle of setting it up on your own PC or device. Now, one cool pre-built Python script that you can access through Google Collab is this Hugging Face Stable Diffusion script, which you can use to create top-notch, clear, and stunning images using fewer resources compared to other image generation tools. It's sort of like a more basic but also more customizable version of Midjourney and Leonardo that creates images based on your prompts. But what makes it stand out? Well, it's totally free. While Leonardo has its free version with limits, Google Collab Stable Diffusion lets you go wild. You can create and edit as many images as you want, so make sure to finish this video. And don't think about clicking away. Just think about the possibilities. You can use this to generate images for picture books and graphic novels, set up a mysterious Instagram profile, or even design a logo with a unique touch. So, in today's video, I'll walk you through how to generate a plethora of images for free, tweak the manual seed, create a grid of images, and even alter the aspect ratio of your images. Stick around till the end because you don't want to miss this. Okay, to get started, make sure you're logged into a Google account and then head to the link in the description under Google Collab Stable Diffusion. It's a pre-built Google Collab Stable Diffusion script. Make sure to follow that step because this is by far the fastest way to get going. Now, once you're logged in, don't be alarmed by the sea of Python code. We'll just be tweaking some slight details and running the code blocks. Okay, to begin, navigate to the upper right corner of Google Collab. Click on the File option and then select Save a Copy in Drive from the drop-down menu. So what this action does is saves a personalized copy of the document to your Google Drive. Now, to install Stable Diffusion on your Google Collab, just click the Run button on the left side until you reach the Prompt cell. Collab will give you a heads up with a warning saying it's unauthorized code, but don't fret because you can just ignore the warning and click Run anyway. This warning pops up every time you try to run someone else's notebooks on Google Collab. Run each code cell by clicking the play buttons, one after another, working your way down the page. This process will establish the Stable Diffusion runtime and install the necessary software packages. And I suggest giving it a few minutes to wrap up. Keep an eye out for that satisfying green tick next to each button. That means the cell has successfully finished running. If you skip this step, you won't be able to use Google Collab Stable Diffusion. Once the installation is complete, you're good to go for generating an image. And you'll see this process is pretty straightforward. Just go to the prompt cell, delete the default astronaut cowboy prompt, and put in your own. For instance, you could type a monkey riding a horse in a market full of glitter. Once you're done with that, just hit the run button and give it a few seconds. And after those few seconds, take a look at the fantastic image we've created. If you want to save it, just right-click with your mouse and select download. Now for a different example, you can type something like, create a busy city with a lot of Martians on planet Mars under a red sunny sky. And voila, check out our newly generated incredible image here. Now, as we scroll down, there's more stuff to check out. Here we are introduced to manual seed adjustments. If you run the cell above a bunch of times, you'll get different pictures each time, but they're all saved under a special code called a manual seed. If you use the same manual seed, you'll always get that exact same picture from the same prompt. For example, if we switch it to 1023, the image changes. But if we go back to 1024, it will show the same image we generated earlier. So basically, the manual seed is like your map. If you're generating images and you find one you like but want to go back later, you can always use the manual seed to get right back to that same image. Now, scrolling down more, we're looking at adjusting the number of inference steps. Here you can change how many steps it takes to figure things out using the num_inference_steps thing. Usually more steps means better results, and Stable Diffusion does pretty well with just 50 steps, which is the default. But if you're in a hurry, you can use a smaller number. I mean, look at the next cell. It's using the same seed as before, but with fewer steps, like 15. Now, if you crank that number up to 50, you'll see the image is looking sharper and better. Now, if you want to improve that image that we made earlier, just change the number and you'll get a better result from that image. Okay, now comes the exciting part of our tutorial, which is generating a bunch of images in one go. Scroll down a bit until you spot the section where we mess with the number of images. So you just switch that part to whatever number you fancy. Like let's say, for example, we go for 5 images. But remember, the number of images should match the number of columns or it won't work. If you're feeling creative and want a variety of images, you can also tweak your prompt here. For instance, you could type, create a business logo about a car with a rock and roll themed store. Hit that button once again, and like any other software, the more images you ask for, the longer it's gonna take. But while we're waiting for the results, remember that the pictures will always be square, but don't worry because by the end of this video, I'll show you how to create non-square images, and I'll also share the ultimate tip on how to generate higher quality images, just like this one. So, now that our results are in, check out the array of images Stable Diffusion whipped up. You got a bunch of choices for your brand logo now. To save them, just right-click and hit download. You'll notice the image is a combo of 5 pictures in one frame. Cool, right? But now let's level up the coolness with the feature that lets us create a grid of images. Similar to the last feature, you can whip up multiple images at once. Scroll down a bit and here you can tweak the number of columns and rows. So for instance, let's go for 4 columns and 5 rows. You can also switch up your prompt here. For instance, let's go with a man walking in the galaxy with his cat. Now, be patient for a minute. While waiting for the results, peek at the bottom left. That's where you can see the available storage. Once it's full, feel free to delete some images or storage to create more. And after just a few minutes, here are the results. We've generated 20 images in one go. It's pretty awesome, right? And just like any other process, to save the images, just right-click and save. Now, let's dive into the part where we can change the aspect ratio of our images. Head over to the feature for creating non-square images. Stable Diffusion usually makes 512 by 512 pixel images, but you can easily change that to create different shapes like portraits or landscapes. For the best results, make sure both the height and width are multiples of 8. Avoid going below 512 to keep the image quality good. Don't go over 512 in both directions, or it might repeat parts of the image and lose overall coherence. To make non-square images, set one dimension to 512 and use a larger value for the other. That's the key to creating cool and diverse images. If you want a landscape image, set the width to 768 and the height to 512. For a portrait image, simply swap the landscape size using 512 for the width and 768 for the height. As you can see, you can also change up your prompt here. But for this step, let's stick with the prompt we used earlier. Now look at this. We've just made a wide landscape image based on that prompt. Even though some of these pictures might not look great, there's a trick to make them even clearer, more beautiful, and more accurate. So here's the tip. Scroll up until you find the Import Torch section. If you really want the best accuracy, remove the torch_type=torch.float16 part of this code. But keep in mind, it'll use more memory. Make sure to run the required cells again. For the prompt we used earlier, add more details to make the generated image more accurate. For example, let's enhance the prompt we used before and make it visualize a futuristic Martian metropolis where sleek metallic buildings soar into the crimson sky. The city is a dazzling blend of advanced technology and innovative architecture seamlessly integrated with the Martian landscape. Picture bustling streets filled with hover vehicles zipping by, their trails leaving streaks of light against the red backdrop. Martian inhabitants, adorned in unique space-age attire, move about purposefully, their daily lives interwoven with the hum of interplanetary activity. Then hit that run button again. You see that? Take a look and compare it to the previous one. The image without the torch code feels more realistic, unlike the earlier one that had sort of a robotic vibe. So in a nutshell, Google Collab's Stable Diffusion is your ticket to crafting loads of images, tailoring them to any size you fancy, and conjuring up detailed masterpieces, and it's all for free. Sure, it might not have the bells and whistles of fancy tools like Midjourney, but it gets the job done and the price is right. Whether you're budget savvy or just keen on creating awesome images on a dime, Google Collab Stable Diffusion is your trusty sidekick. If you found this video helpful and you're craving more AI wisdom, make sure to obliterate the like and subscribe button. Trust me, you won't want to miss the next tech adventure we've got in store. Dive into more AI awesomeness by exploring our other videos. For more awesome AI tech tips, catch us in the next video. See you there.